down for about 6 weeks this summer.
Really?
Yes, sir. But we had the Parthenon going.
Yeah.
So we're still able to hit our, at least our minimum of 20 enrollments each month.
Yes.
You know, and without the Parthenon, you know, if we had just relied on that one bucket, you know, it wouldn't have worked. So 2019, we were at 960.
Okay. So you were down a little bit last year.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. And when we started working together, you were doing what?
I was doing around 500 a year
when
we first started. And it was the hamster wheel, no memberships, $99 a month.
And big
serious churn. Yeah, high dropout rate, and that is something that we're really proud of. We're at 4% this year, and that's a huge improvement for us. So we're constantly refining that.
But for other people's benefit, one is what was your dropout rate when we first looked?
It was 16%.
16% a month. Wow. Okay, and everybody put that in. Wow. She has gone from 16% to 4%.
Really good.
And on track, 2%.
Yes, sir. Yeah, honing those, that whole communication with that first 2 months, and I have a lot of work to still do in that area.
Yeah.
You know, very focused on the end retention, the black belts, and the nurturing them, but I need to do better at the front end.
Yeah. And you were charging $99 a month?
$99 a month, no membership.
Yeah. And what's the demographics of your area look like?
The demographics, we're in a very rural area. Our county has about 100,000 people in it, and Johnson City, where I live, is 65,000.
Yeah.
And it's one of the poorest areas in the nation, the Appalachian area. And, you know, median income really is like $35,000 a year. Implement, refine, keep your eye on the ball. 2021 for me has been, I thought 2020 was a rough year. 2021 has been significantly more difficult for me, and just trying to say no matter what, keep my focus on keeping that school running and keeping it alive and keeping it thriving. And you guys help with that, absolutely.
Well, if you don't mind sharing, you started the year with everybody having COVID.
We did. We had the kind of what Rachel's gone through. We started our year with that. And just the pure exhaustion of going through 2020 and then everybody being, I was very, very sick, very sick. And thankful to get back started, and thankful for this group for lifting me up.
Yeah.
Definitely, when you talk about Rachel and you say there's a family here, and I talked to a few people because people will call and ask about being in the group, and I said, you know, you preach, don't throw them over the fence, but you also practice that, and you practice that with